Hey guys, Lucas here and welcome at kNews.space, your totally legit source for all things space and, of course, the go-to place to escape the echo chamber on the internet. That's why today we're going to talk about SpaceX. But seriously, if you're here for the first time, do not subscribe if you expect SpaceX content only. Here at kNews we like all things space, except maybe the orange rocket. Just kidding, there is also a special place in my heart for SLS. Speaking of SLS, what is going on with the SpaceX launch system? There are some new developments at the Starship front just before Elon Musk's update talk. He's going to explain whatever is going on at SpaceX and how their plans evolved, so don't miss that one if you can. I'm going to link the live stream below in case there is one, but you can of course also follow me on Twitter for updates on that. So it seems like Starship went through another design iteration, but I'm not entirely sure how much the current prototypes that are being built resemble the final version already. Especially when you are still in an experimental stage, things can change quite drastically, so it makes sense to build a platform for different takes on the same problem. That means the current prototypes could be built to support different wing types should one prove too unreliable. Fact is, we're back at two controlled surfaces in the back and two in the front. The landing legs will apparently extend or be mounted on the bottom, but I'm not sure to which degree that will be solved on the prototype. It could be just some solid ones to not make it overly complex in the beginning. This new design will make Starship definitely look a lot more like a canard space shuttle again, so how similar are they? I can't go into full detail on that because the space shuttle consisted of a million different parts, but I look at it with a strong degree of abstraction. A thermos bottle with flaps to the left and the marshmallow plane to the right. I, by the way, mounted it on a stick because it can't really fly, just fall very gracefully. So there is at least one similarity. The big difference though is Starship is a giant stainless steel fuel tank that has enough thrust to lift itself up. Whereas the shuttle was more like an advanced, reusable payload fairing with crew cabin. The main engines were fed by the giant orange tank that detaches during flight and were mounted on the shuttle for reuse. The shuttle itself only used the rather small thrusters next to them to move around in space, not the main engines. These were pretty much several tons of dead weight in space it had to carry around everywhere it went, and Starship will do the same as it won't really need all its engines in space nor during landing. So there is another similarity and downside of a reusable launch vehicle that doubles as a ferry in space. I think it's still important to understand the sheer scale of things. Starship is like a space shuttle with orange tank still attached, which would sit on an even bigger orange tank. That's what you actually have to compare to Starship rather than the space shuttle itself. But let's quickly remove that one before someone gets ideas. What SpaceX basically did was to combine both the external tank and space shuttle into one vehicle. They ditched the capability to land on a runway and instead pack in spare fuel to make use of the main engines to land vertically. I believe they could have went for the glide approach, but that means you'll always need a very long runway, not to mention that would only really work on Earth. SpaceX famously pushes for Mars, which of course has no runways and a much lower air density. All Starship needs its wings or control surfaces for right now is to efficiently orient the rocket during re-entry without using much propellant to not get out of control, and that part will really be the hardest. A long tube has no passive re-entry stability so that it could survive an uncontrolled re-entry like a capsule. In that regard, it is indeed very much like the space shuttle. It could in theory be able to control itself using thrusters in an emergency, but if you'd carry enough propellant to do that, why use the wings in first place? This means using flappy wings there is no way Starship will have enough propellant and maybe even thrust to control itself without it. It would simply make no sense to use these wings otherwise. These wings will therefore be Starship's Achilles heel, so to speak, its weakness, and it doesn't have to land like a shuttle to become a shuttle, metaphorically speaking. I actually wouldn't be surprised if SpaceX would ditch them at some point, not entirely, but as an active control surface. What I mean by that is SpaceX could, and that's the vibe I'm currently getting, only use these wings to make Starship passively stable during re-entry, like a quasi-capsule pretty much. No flappy wings. One locked mode for hypersonic and another unlocked mode for supersonic flight. The rest could be done using good old thrust, but for that they had to develop some kind of methane engine, which they currently haven't as far as I know. However, they could still develop it and meanwhile use their regular RCS on their prototypes, where carrying more fuel doesn't really matter. So, does Starship turn into Space Shuttle? I'm not sure yet. There certainly is a chance, since SpaceX is a private company and they don't have unlimited funding. They could run into problems they can't solve quickly enough to run out of it. But I also believe SpaceX has enough control authority to turn it all around, should it head that way. A therefore maybe more interesting question now is, will it turn into a quasi-capsule? That would be seriously good news in my opinion. I really hope you will hear more of that in Elon's talk, but please keep in mind that last one is very speculative and I could be totally wrong. I personally just don't like these flappy wings at all, especially when it comes to re-entry. Big moving parts need a more complex heat shield solution and of course steel expands when heated up, which means the hinges have to either be super cooled or designed to work in two entirely different regimes. But I'm also not a total ignorant and know that SpaceX knows what they are doing and whatever they come up with, it's going to work anyways in the end. It's really only a question of time and whether they be able to fund it. Some say Starlink is going to solve all these funding issues, but that will take a couple years and I don't believe SpaceX wants to set up the whole fleet with Falcon 9 alone. A fully reusable and therefore cheaper vehicle would surely be better. I guess we have to wait and see. Okay, that's it for this video. Feel free to share your opinion in the comments and if you want to support my original content and help me to make more of it, please consider a channel membership. It's only $1.99 and you'd become a official kNews booster. Thank you for your time, for your support and of course, thank you for watching.